Hands of applause to our Washington team. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. It's a wonderful night, isn't it? Amen. Can we lift up our hands and we really bless God? Amen. For this night. Amen. Can we say thank you, Lord Jesus?
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We're here to share the word. Amen. 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 I'm just honored. You know, I didn't really think I would be standing in front of my father, amen, the father of the house. But I bless God for whatever is happening, amen. Because he says his ways are better and his ways are the best, amen. Amen. He says our thoughts are not his thoughts, amen. So we can plan things according to what we understand, but that's not really, it doesn't mean that God has the same thought that we have. God might have another plan which is better, because he said my plans are not to harm you but are to prosper you. So whatever happens in his presence, it's not to harm us but it is to prosper us. Amen. 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 He says when we lift up his name, his glory will come down. Amen. I want us to go on to turn our Bibles to John 3 verse 16. Amen. Amen. Before I say something from, well, before I read my word, I just want to take this time again and really greet everyone. Amen. Feel greeted. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. We are here to worship tonight. Amen. Glory. Hallelujah. Amen. And we are still going to worship God. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. We are still going to worship God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
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 Can we at least respond when I say amen? Hallelujah. So I can really feel better and I really get that. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Can we bow down our heads as I give the mic to the Father and he really blesses us. Amen.
Father, we thank you even at this particular time that we want to really honor your name for having received your word so as to we may receive the rights to be called your children. Father, we know at this time that we understand your language and you are going to speak our hearts even through your servant. Father God, we pray that may your anointing for speaking your word and may you anoint us for hearing your word in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you. Amen.
Amen.
Can we read John 3:16? Amen. My goodness flows, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Amen. Can I repeat it again? The Bible says, for God so loved the world. Amen.
Amen.
That he gave his only begotten son. His only. His one and only. Amen.
Amen.
He gave. And listen, as it goes on, it says that whoever, I just want us to really underline this word, whoever, in my understanding, when we try to define the word whoever, it includes everyone, irregardless of your category that the world has categorized you into. Amen. So this word does not care about your category, whether you're a minister or what, it includes you too. And it says, God so loved the world that whosoever, amen, it means it doesn't matter where you are. Listen as it goes on. Whoever believes in him. So it doesn't matter who you are, as long as you know what, you believe in him.
Oh,
and it continues, it says, should not perish. So who's whosoever is believing in God must not perish.
Yeah.
It can help. tomorrow. I can decide that I'm studying because tomorrow I want to pass the test. Amen. But if I have failed the test, one, and I'm about, I've written test two, I cannot decide that tomorrow test I'm going to pass test one because test one has passed.
And the glory of God arrived, and we know
offering comes, nothing which is not supposed to stand will stand. Because his body is alive. I just want us to all stand right now. We come and say, God, we love you. We love you, God. We love you, God. We love you, Father. We love you, God. We love you, Heavenly Father. We love you, God. We love you, God. We love you, Lord Jesus. Because you are great. And you are wonderful, God. There's no one like you, Father God. There's no one like you, Lord Jesus. There's no one like you, Father. Amen. He's great. There's a song in Zulu. It goes like they say washalwa phansi. So they sat down in heaven. And then they decided about our lives. And the word of God says, when they sat in heaven, we were not born. And the word was not here. And your life was, they sketched your life. They said, my son is going to go here. And he goes here. He goes there. And he goes there. And he will reach this and this and this.
Amen.
And it's been written in heaven. Okay. And whatever is written in heaven shall never perish. Because God says, I am not the God to lie.
Yeah.
Listen, God, if he said, I'm about to prosper you, he's going to prosper you.
Yeah.
Because he himself said, I'm not a man that I should lie, which means I cannot change what I have said.
Amen.
But what I have said is final.
Hallelujah.
And that is, I love you.
Hallelujah.
Amen. I want to welcome back our worshipers as we want to continue worshiping God. Amen.
Amen.
Again, I say, I want you to take this word that I'm going to say and you run with it throughout the night. He is alive. Amen. Listen, earlier I said, you don't have a reason to go back to the tomb and you start mourning because he's no longer there. The grave is useless. Precious. And when he says, I love you, featuring. There's a song in song, it says, it says, his love, it's not like a human being love. His love does not change. It does not die. It does not get tired of, regardless of how many times we disobey him, it does not get tired. Amen. Because he said it in his way, that I will love you and I love you. Because he said in John 3:16, he said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but should have everlasting life. He knows it all.
Amen.
Because he's the King of Kings.
Yes.
The Father of the fatherless.
Oh, Jesus.
Lion of Judah. He's here.
He's here.
Come on. know that God lives in you. Come on, I'm telling you, the secret bishop is smiling. He's in you. You don't need to go that way in that way. Trying to search for him. You can just get in your knees and you say, God, I need you.
We're gonna dance.
Yeah.
And then after
carefully, I would ask to excuse the worship team for a little bit of time. And then I would remain behind with CJ and Uwaz. I know. There's something that the Lord has said to me. And I actually planned with the Holy Spirit that we're going to be ministering it tonight. Hallelujah.